We have already done the data entry form. Now it's time to program the login form. Because we have a one user that has been entered by us. His password is also known to us. And we can now start to program the login form to verify that the login occurs correctly. If the user is valid, then he should be taken to a new page. If he is not valid, a suitable message should be shown to him. Okay, let us see how to do it. Before we can proceed to the actual coding, we should make two provisions. One is for the message that appears just below the form. If the user logs in successfully, then he has to be taken to a new page also. And in case he fails, he should be kept on the same page and a message should be shown that invalid user or password, like that story. So we'll begin by doing this, then we'll proceed to do this. This is the page that we have. This is the login form that we already have. This is the TBL user, the model that comes to this form. This is the form. We also need to make this correction because this one has been wrongly typed by us, user phone and text box for. So this has to be changed to password. Let us do that first outrightly. We'll write password text box for x goes to x dot password x dot password. But this password is going to create problems for us because the type of password is byte. And we have already removed annotations on this password here for a string. Now what do we do? We have to collect the password as a string. Because that is the only option with us. Password has to be captured as a string and not as a byte. This is not possible for us. Without complicating the code. So we need this password to be corrected. We want to capture password as a string so that when it comes into our action method, we can use it in whatever way we want. But at least here it should be coming as a string. Now the issue is that this is our model generated by the EDM. It has only three properties. And we want a shadow property, like a dummy property for password. So we'll have to add one dummy property to this file. If you see this one, this is the inner class that we wrote here. We can add a dummy property to the partial class TBL user somewhere here. This property exists on our partial class TBL user. And its annotation will have to be reflected in the inner class somewhere here. This property will help us capture the password as a string. And then once the string is available inside our model, inside our action method, we can then read that string, convert into byte, or do whatever we want to do with it. So let us do this, that we add a dummy property to this partial class. I am adding it here. Public string dummy password get set. Corresponding to this dummy password, I am adding one required string length. We agree that we'll allow passwords of only 10 characters long. So to this file we have done two modifications. One is brought a dummy password to the public partial class TBL user. Second is to put a corresponding annotation in the MD class here. Now let us come back to our form index.cshtml. We'll now modify it. We'll have to build it first so that it comes as a compiled one. X dot dummy password, and this will be X dot dummy password. Before proceeding further, let us at least run it to see that the dummy password is actually working for us or not. Yes, it is working. We could have given our own custom message. It's the message automatically generated by the annotation. But otherwise it is working correctly. Next, we will put a message here towards the end of this page and we'll write @ if viewBag.message. We can write if not string dot is null or empty. You can give any colors to these pens if you want. Dot message. Now if some message property is set on the view bag, then it will be displayed here. This will be useful for displaying invalid user ID or password because the same form will have to be shown back to the user. One small mistake is here. This should not be text box for, it should be password for. So that the password appears as a star when the user is typing something. Running this one to see. So this one is working. And I find one more thing, that the length should be restricted to 10. The password entry should be restricted to 10. HTML attributes new max length is equal to 10. So this is the complete form as far as the login form is concerned. Now we'll also have to, before we proceed any further, we'll also have to make a provision for a page where the user will be taken if he logs in successfully. For that I'll come to the outer controller, home controller, and there I'll add another action result. Just giving any name, welcome, return view. Now I'll add a view to this, welcome. Only message is to be shown, so no strongly typed or anything is required. We'll write here the message, welcome, you are authenticated. Welcome, you are authenticated. So we have added a page to the outer controller here. Areas, we are having a login area, its own controller and all story. And to the outer controller we have added a welcome, so that when the user has successfully logged in, he'll be brought back to the outer controller, or he could be otherwise taken to other area inside, whatever, that's a different story. So our welcome is in place now. We have to now begin the coding process. When the user will click this submit button on the login form, he will be posted back to where? To the same action method that brought you here. That is, you will have to be posted back to the index, because it is through the index of the login area that you were brought here. In other words, I have to create an HTTP post index method with an argument of the type TBL user, because this information will have to be received there so that we can act on it. Let us have a look at our, this is our user controller, and let me scroll to the top. This is the index method that takes us to that view. See this top. This view is the login page. We are coming through a GET request here. We have to now add another action method here, which will receive the post. When the user clicks that submit button, user ID, password, and the submit button, when the user clicks on this submit button, he should be posted to the post counterpart of this one. Let us add it quickly. For me, the best way is copy, paste, put the annotation HTTP post, and here add TBL user T. I'll put a breakpoint here to verify that I do reach here and I do get the values in T. Run it. Now I am typing user ID Hovan. It has to be in the email format. So I'll write support@hovantrainings.com, and I'm writing password 123456. Login. The breakpoint is hit. And what does T contain? T contains my dummy password, and it also contains the user email. This means my things are working. So all I have to do is write the C# program here to verify the credentials of the user. Most of my work is done. What has to be done? If you see, how are we storing the password? Suppose this is the password of the user. His password is Hovan. If he types Hovan, then this password should be converted into SSH hash, and whatever is the result should be compared with what is in the database, because database contains the hash. So as my first step, I should take out the dummy password out of this and convert it into hash. That is the first thing I should do. And then I will have to compare this hash with what is coming from the database. Okay. I'll write byte array dummy hash is equal to, if you remember, I already have written a function hash value yesterday in the previous. This converts a string into byte array. So I'll come to the top and use its services. Pass what? T dot dummy password. I can write one more thing here. If model state dot is valid, then I'm going through this story. Else I'll put view bag dot message is equal to some validation error so that this appears on that form. So I have got the byte array from the password that the user has entered. Next, now I have to take out the password corresponding to the user that has been entered from the database. So I'll write using ctxt is equal to new here. I'll take out the user tbl u is equal to ctxt dot tbl users dot single or default. Single or default tbl user x goes to user email is double equal to t dot user email. So what we are trying to do is we are going to find that record from the database for which the email tell is this one. If not found, if null is double equal to u, if it is not found, then we can simply write viewbag dot message you are not registered. And if the user is found, else we can now check out his byte. We'll write byte array password is equal to u dot password. Here we should make a comparison of your dummy hash and this. We can do a byte by byte comparison. We can write bool b both match is equal to true, for each byte b I have to use for loop here, for int I is equal to 0, I less than, I know the length is 20, however to be on, it's actually 20, there's no problem, both are of equal length. You can even write 20 here. I plus plus if what is that dummy hash dummy hash I is not equal to password I. B both match is equal to false and break off. So here we can test if B both match return redirect to action. What is the name of the action? Welcome. And what is the controller name? It is home. And we'll complete it in a moment. If they don't match, then we'll write else view back dot message is equal to invalid credentials. Columns, there is a slight problem here. This model state is always going to be invalid because T will contain password as null. This line will pose a problem for us because T is going to contain password as a null here. Either we manually remove those errors here or we simply remove this code so that this model state remains valid, because it would be invalid otherwise. T is non-nullable, so when the data is coming from there, password property being null will cause this to go invalid. So it will always be invalid if we leave it in this state. So the best thing is that you write your own pre-validation code here that the password is coming okay or not, or similarly you can write your own validation code for the email. So if you push that code here, so instead of taking that model dot is valid, we can push through our own validation code here, server side validation. If not string dot is null, or this server side validation code will help us prevent the problem that will arise because model state will not be valid here, because certain properties like t dot password, they'll always be null. So we have added this code here. The second thing that we need to work on is on if both match, where to redirect. If we redirect the user to welcome home, then this has to be inside the current area. So we have to take him to the outer area, outer common place. So since we want to redirect the user to the common outer area, we'll have to write redirect to action welcome inside home controller of which area? Empty area, that is of no specific area, that is lying outside in the solution explorer. This is the areas folder, and here we are here in the login area, and we have to come to the welcome method in the home controller that is lying outside of all the areas. So we have put new area is equal to empty, this one. Let us run it now to see. Type some user that doesn't exist. Type some password login, you are not registered. So this works. Let us now write a user that does exist. So let us check up the user first in our database. Show table data. We added z at z.com yesterday with the password hoven. So we'll check that user now. z@z.com. Typing the wrong password. Invalid credentials. Noel type the right password. Hovan. Login. Welcome, you are authenticated. So it works now. Okay, let me revise off all the things with you. This was our form where we added a dummy password to our model so that a string is carried over to the action where we'll verify the credentials. Then we have a viewBag.message so that it appears only if certain message is stored in the viewBag. So it will typically contain messages of invalid user ID or something like that. Once this form was complete, this submit button posted to this index HTTP post. Here we did a server side validation that user email and password are indeed there. Then we converted our dummy password to hash, and then we looked up from the database that particular user. If that user was not found, we said you are not registered, and if he was found, then we took out his password as a byte array and compared them one to one. We know this length of hashing is 20, so we hard coded this one, and then we wrote appropriate messages. If both match, redirect to welcome home area, otherwise invalid credentials. So we'll close it right now. Thanks.